oceanic environment.
Yeah, but listen, if we consider the fate of the continental runoff, most of the material is trapped in the shelf. And only a small percentage really reach the open ocean. And also, well, it this depends on the grain sizes of the material for the coarser of the sand and so on. But in general, I think about 95% of the material, which is coming from the continent via the big rivers or so, is fixed to the in the shelf area.
Okay.
And then, okay, more minerals, and therefore also I think the dissolved elements, they do not stay, they do not precipitate on the shelf, they go into the open ocean. And from the clay minerals, it's only illite which has a chance. All the other minerals stay on the shelf. Therefore, we have these thick shelf sequences, but nevertheless, within the shelf sequence, we have the organic carbon enrichment and get high potential for fuel and gas and so on.
Yeah.
Very clear.
Well, okay. The shelf is very narrow. That's my what I think.
Not to get the wrong impression of this picture here. This is not the continental shelf. This is just a seamount in our abyssal area of the nodule fields. And as you see that, this picture also shows we have the transition from the typical digenetic mixed type nodule growth to the hydrogenetic growth and finally to the manganese crust growth, which is maybe 1,000 or 2,000 meter higher. And this is also shown by this graph here. But this is not the continental slope. It's just an abyssal seamount where also crust can grow.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
I think it's only a remark to Professor Halbach. I think it's at the end of the day an academician has clarified all our doubts about the nodules are concerned. And I think it's interesting, you know, he has explained to, you know, he explained about the entire process of hydrogenase and the diagenic type of nodules, as well as the importance of comparing this to Peru area also is an important, I think, a sort of element and all that. Otherwise, actually, the entire area, it cannot be understood completely. And the so-called sort of a hyperbolic, you know, regression and all this thing, you know, he has clearly explained, actually, in terms of his, you know, graphical representation.
I show you my, this is my idea, but maybe Charles and I, we talked about this matter and understand very well this will not be included in the authorities' report. But we have the idea to write a paper, to make a publication on this program. And then we include the Peru Basin data and ask me if we can use also the data from the report and write a paper for the common, for the scientific community. This is one idea we have, and we will ask me then if we can use also some results of this geochemical model undertaking of the authority for this kind of publication. Then we put in the Peru Basin ideas and the Peru Basin data.
He required to be applauded at least along this.
I agree. I agree completely.
Give him a big hand.
Thank you.
Further questions? Ni?
No, this is not a question. So if the other question. I wish to invite all participants to dinner tomorrow evening. We will arrange the bus, which will come and pick up everybody at 7 o'clock. It's a location not very far from the court.